Hi, I'm Jackie Britton. Let's continue our Football Friday's flashback, this time our fourth game of the regular season on September 25th. It was the Tucker Tigers and the ML King Lions, and this was an interesting matchup because the Tigers were 2-2. They were plagued with injuries, and they really needed a big win. So this one was going to be interesting to see how they would adjust with the young talent that they have, and here's a look at how it went.
Hand off Terrell. That might be a safety. And it is. Yeah. Kentavis Terrell tackled in the end zone for a safety.
And Cecil Stallings, big number 99. One of the guys in there. Look at number 14, Joshua Van. Good penetration right here.
Second down, goal to go. Broadwater gets in this time as he bowls his way into the end zone. 5-yard touchdown run for Nick Broadwater, his sixth touchdown of the season, and Tucker has an 8-0 lead. Adam Lippe is on for the PAT. Lippe, 18 of 19 on his extra point attempt kicks this season, puts it through, and Tucker has a 9-0 lead. So first and 10 now, Rigby back to pass. They're going for the home run. Wide open is Van. That is going to be an easy touchdown for the Tigers. A 65-yard touchdown pass from Garrett Rigby to Joshua Van, and it is 15-0.
Well, you give this Tucker staff credit for throwing out some trick plays when they first get the ball. We saw the Wildcat play the last drive to get positive yards, 6-7 yards in that first carry, and then right there, right after the muffed fourth down play, the turnover on downs, they come right out, go for the home run, catch that Lions secondary sleeping, and they're back on the board again. Well, that's just tough. You're trying to coach your kids on what they did wrong on one play while the next bang-bang play happens. And as you talked about, that could have been a touchdown for you. Instead, it's 6 going the other way. Make it 7.
Lippe with the PAT, and Tucker has a 16-0 lead as we take a look at our TCSG touchdown replay.
Yeah, take a look at this right here. This is a play all the way. Rigby knows exactly where he's going. The defense just falls asleep. There's nobody in the screen. No white jerseys within 10 yards of him. He could have somersaulted his way into the end zone if he wanted to. One more look. I believe we've got another shot. The end zone camera right there. He knows right away. Rigby, it's just pitch and catch. You do this on a Saturday afternoon during the summer. Like you practiced all year long. No defenders there. Easy pitch and catch. One of the easiest touchdowns this team will have the entire season. Tucker all smiles, and all of a sudden the Lions have got their work cut out for them. Down 16-0 already, and we're still in the first quarter. Also, here we go. Unbalanced lineup. Fourth down here.
Clark running for the pylon. And did he get there? He did. Touchdown run by Clark. Shot.
Well, it's the same play they tried on the other way where they had the left side, the strong side was loaded with four wide receivers on the left side. Watch this, the TCSG touchdown replay. We saw this before. There are four receivers out to his left. He looks that way to freeze the defense, and then it's a sprint to the cone. Clark, so athletic, we mentioned, first year in the program. He's their leading receiver until after last weekend's game, he was made quarterback. So his first game at quarterback for this Lions team. Shows his athleticism there. And finally, they get on the board. So again, great momentum on offense. They just can't finish. Finally, all their hard work pays off in a touchdown, and they're back in this ballgame 16-6.
6-yard touchdown run for Owen Clark, and now they'll go for two. Clark throws, and nope, still running. Now he throws to the back of the end zone. A nice catch by Kobe Ross, but he was out of the back of the end zone, and so the two-point conversion attempt fails.
I say they run the ball.
They do, and it is a touchdown for Broadwater.
Yeah, he's a bull.
Second touchdown run of the night for Chris Broadwater, and Tucker leads 22-6. Lippe for the PAT, he puts it through, and Tucker with a big touchdown with just 12 seconds to play in the half increases their lead to 23-6. And Broadwater, 14 carries, 63 yards, and a couple of touchdowns in the first two quarters.
It's a great battle between those two.
Fade route, Van, touchdown. Nice execution by the Tucker Tigers right there. Nice touch on the pass. and great recognition by Van to turn around and catch it. 14-yard touchdown pass from Garrett Rigby to Joshua Van. And Tucker has a 30-6 lead. So second down and 9. Right up the middle, Broadwater. Third touchdown run of the night for Chris Broadwater. 13 yards right up the gut. Broadwater, 8 rushing touchdowns now in the first 5 games of the season. As Adam Lippe puts it through the uprights, it is 37-6. Chris Broadwater running big. And the Tigers, 31-point lead. First and 10. Sam Bryant follows his offensive lineman into the end zone for the touchdown. Taj Rankin running convoy for him.
So despite their loss to Tucker, the ML King Lions still improved on their record from last year. They're going into their third season with head coach Nick Kashama. And the Tucker Tigers finished 8-4. They made it to the second round of the playoffs, losing 42-35 to South Forsyth. Don't forget that you can find us on Facebook and Twitter at GPB Sports for all of the high school football news and notes as we continue through the offseason. That will do it for now. For GPB Sports, I'm Jackie Britton.